Hi friend, I am Harish Kambale. In this video, I am going to explain about properties of enzymes. First property of enzyme is all enzymes are protein. So protein is synthesized by living cell. Suppose this is the protein, 100% protein. Proteins are two types, structural protein and functional protein. So enzymes come in the category of functional protein. So all enzymes are protein because the enzyme is a part of protein, but not all proteins are enzyme because some protein is structural and the enzyme synthesized in the living cell only, not in laboratory. Enzyme synthesized by living cell, and each living cell requires its own enzyme for the chemical reactions. So that every cell synthesizes its own enzymes. Enzymes are also endoenzymes and ectoenzymes. So this is the important property of enzyme, is all enzymes are protein. Second important property of enzyme is enzymes have an active site. Active site means in enzyme there are a special structure formed where the substrate bind. That site is called as active site, and every most probable enzymes have active site. So the active site is a important property of enzyme. Then catalytic property. Catalytic property means enzyme increase the rate of biochemically possible reactions. So here the example is catalase. Catalase is an enzyme which convert hydrogen peroxide into water and oxygen. So and at the end of enzyme, at the suffix of enzyme, there is a ASE. This indicated that enzyme is there. So turnover rate means one molecule of enzyme converted how many molecule of substrate into product. So here in this condition, catalase enzyme, this is a single molecule converted 50 lakh molecule of hydrogen peroxides into water and oxygen in a single minute. So this is a huge turnover rate, as well as one molecule of invertase converted 10 lakh sucrose molecules. So this is called as turnover rate. Here this is the enzyme and this is the substrate. Substrate means the substance which is undergoing in the chemical reaction and converted into product. So the substrate converted into product by the help of enzyme. So enzyme is a mediator. Colloidal condition. This is the another property of enzyme. Colloidal conditions means the size of enzymes is here. Catalase enzymes is 248,000 dalton. Urea is 483,000 dalton. So the size of these enzyme molecules are higher than the substrate, is larger molecules. So the colloidal conditions means when they mix in the water, they make a colloidal solution. So colloidal solution means, suppose this is the smaller molecule, they make a solution, and the molecules which is up to 100 nanometer, they make a colloidal solution. So enzyme is a make a colloidal solution, and larger molecule make a suspension solution. So colloidal solutions, because of its size, enzymes make a colloidal solution. Another property of enzyme is specificity. Enzymes have active site, and this active site is a different. So absolute specificity and absolute specificity, there are two specificities here in this condition. See, suppose this is the enzyme and these are various substrate, just like lipid, protein, as well as fats, vitamins, so many molecules present in the solution. But enzymes and their active site, due to the active site, only a particular molecules can bind to the enzymes. So here a blue molecules only attach to the enzyme. As well as in this condition, there are triangular molecules also bind to the enzymes. So this is specificity, not circle, round, hexagonal molecules attached to the active site. So only this blue color and light blue color triangular molecules only bind to the enzymes. But in the absolute specificity, there are only a single, these enzymes only act on a single substrate. This is called as absolute specificity. Only this type of substrate only attached to this active site. So this is called as absolute. And here a specificity, there are two molecules, their shape is, yes, due to its active site, two molecules can attach to this active site. So this is called a specificity, not other molecules can bind to this active site. So enzymes have a specificity. Reversibility of reaction, this is another important property of enzymes. Some enzymes have a reversibility property, means suppose here example fatty acid and glycerol by the help of enzyme lipase converted into fat. Fat is produced from fatty acid and glycerol required lipase enzyme, this enzyme. Same way, when the fat is converted into glycerol and fatty acid require the same enzyme called as lipase. So the lipase enzymes work in the build of fats as well as breakdown of fats. Heat sensitivity. See here the protein, when temperature increased, protein is coagulate and form in the solid. This is liquid state converted into solid one. It is coagulate yellow colors, white colors. This is the white color protein and yellow color is fat. Remember that. So the every enzymes have a heat sensitive. In the higher temperature, 60 to 70 degree temperature, enzymes structure or configuration is changed and enzyme become inactivate or it become coagulate. So this graph suggested that enzyme activity increase in this range, 30 to 50, and below 30 it is low and above 50 there it is a low, or more than 60-70 degrees Celsius enzyme structure or configuration is changed and enzyme become inactive. So the high maximum or optimum temperature for enzyme is 45 degrees Celsius. 40 to 45 degrees Celsius is the optimum temperature of enzyme. So enzyme is a heat sensitive. Enzyme inhibitors, this is the another property of enzyme, in which so enzymes have active site, and in the active site there are special substrate only attached. Suppose this is the enzyme, and in this enzyme there is this one is the active site, and in that active site this enzyme fit and converted into product. Again these enzymes and this substrate bind together, form complex, and it is breakdown. So that's where a single molecules can converted a thousands or lakhs of substrate molecule into product. Sometime what happen, some molecules are called as inhibitor. They have a shape as like substrate. So this is the same shape of as like substrate. So this enzymes and this is the active site. So for that active site, they both of them substrate and inhibitor competed, and if the inhibitor attached to the active site, these enzymes become functionless. So this is called as inhibitors. This is inhibit the action of enzyme due to attachment. Some inhibitors attached to active site, some inhibitors attached to the enzyme's other site. So there are different types of inhibitors. So this is competitive inhibitors. This is a competition for the active site, because these two inhibitor and substrate competed for active site. And if the inhibitor successful, enzymes stop their activity. So this is a called as enzyme inhibitor. It inhibits the action of enzyme. There is no formation of substrate due to this inhibitor. pH sensitive. So enzymes. See this graph. Enzyme is pH sensitive. So this is a 2 pH, 3 pH, 4 pH. Some enzymes work in lower pH, acidic pH, called as pepsin. Pepsin is enzyme present in the stomach, and it work in acidic pH, 2 pH. Inverted 4.5 pH here. Inverted here 4.5 pH inverted. Amylase, maltase, urease. These enzymes work in a 7 neutral pH, 7 pH. Trypsin 7 pH. ATP 9 pH. So alkaline pH here, basic pH here. So most of the enzymes work in say 7 pH. So this is the optimum pH of enzyme, but some enzymes require acidic environment, just like pepsin. It work only in low pH, means acidic pH. So pH enzymes are pH sensitive. pH means power of hydrogens or hydrogen ion concentration. Thank you.